Hey folks, my name is Jared Manninen, and I'd like to welcome you to my monthly newsletter. At the beginning of each month, I publish a newsletter filled with photos, videos, artwork, links to my other projects, and an essay that I hope will provide food for thought and a starting point for meaningful conversation. These newsletters essentially allow me to compile all of the work I produced during the past month and share it in a convenient location. Keep in mind, however, that these video versions of my newsletters have been modified from their original format. And although I've been publishing my monthly newsletter since 2017, I've only started producing them in this video format since 2022. So if you want to read any of my previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com. Thoughts about embracing agency in our lives. One of the cross-country skiing videos that I produced last month was in response to a question posed by one of my viewers. The individual asked me how long it should take a person to feel comfortable enough on cross-country skis to stop at will while skiing downhill. Regardless of your snow sports background, performing a snowplow on cross-country skis is not very easy until you've learned and then adequately practiced proper technique. And even then, it can be challenging depending on the snow conditions and angle of terrain on which you're skiing. What piqued my interest about this question, though, was its underlying theme of being out of control. Although it was hyperbole, the person used the phrase that he couldn't snowplow to save his life. Obviously, he could to some degree because he contacted me afterwards, but essentially he found himself skiing out of control, which is bad for everyone involved. I hear this sentiment every time I teach beginner cross-country skiers basic downhill technique, so the question wasn't out of the ordinary. But it did resonate with me because lately I've been trying to cultivate not necessarily more control, but rather more agency in my life. A very simple definition of agency is that it's about making choices that have impact. In this context, impact can also mean results or consequences. So by taking this action, you hope to create this result. Now, a lot of people might equate this with having control. However, agency and control are not exactly synonymous. That said, I'd argue that the intention behind trying to gain more agency in our lives is fueled by a desire to stack the deck in our favor. Unfortunately, no matter how much of a chess master we think we are, predictable results are seldom a guarantee. Once you've made your decision and implemented your plan of attack, what happens next is out of your hands. In other words, the only real control we have in life is that of our emotions, thoughts, and actions. Beyond that, it's chaos. The beginner cross-country skier can control his attitude, choices, and actions, and by extension, his skis. He can't always control, however, what happens after initiating the snowplow. For example, the snow might be too icy or hill too steep for the snowplow to be an effective method of stopping, or perhaps the skier catches an edge of their ski on a snow-covered obstacle, causing them to fall down. Again, we can't control external factors, but we can gain more agency through diligent study and practice. That's because in order to make choices that'll have impact, we need to possess knowledge relevant to our endeavor, and then we have to become proficient in using that knowledge, whatever that looks like. Are we an artist trying to paint a certain type of landscape scene by throwing everything at the canvas and hoping for the best? Or have we researched and practiced the specific techniques or sequence of brush strokes or layers of paint to yield the image in our mind's eye? We can't truly control the results of our actions, but by developing a deep base of knowledge regarding our given endeavor, we should be able to adapt to any outcome. Essentially, at a certain level of proficiency, all of our decisions will have impact. So even if the consequences of our actions could be considered bad, we may still be able to salvage something out of the wreckage. The reality is that we can't know everything, so there will always be variables and results with which we'll just have to accept. But this is okay because this is part of what makes life exciting. Now, embracing agency in our lives doesn't mean that every decision we make needs to be a life changer. I totally advocate being present in the moment and being conscious of our decisions, but not every choice really matters, right? Are you going to wear the blue pants or the gray ones today? Who cares? Unless, of course, those pants are part of some type of professional uniform or dress code, then it probably does matter. But the majority of decisions we make on a daily basis are usually pretty benign and can be substituted relatively easily for another option, so most things just aren't worth losing sleep over. On that note, exercising restraint by choosing our battles is part of creating agency in our lives. It's like the concept of using leverage rather than power to move something. Leverage equates to choosing the right time and place in which to apply pressure in order to create the maximum effect. On the other hand, the application of power can often just be indiscriminate and therefore wasted. Again, all of this boils down to having more knowledge about the situation so that you can make the most informed decision possible, i.e., make the greatest impact. If you've kept in touch, you probably can guess some of the reasons why I've been trying to gain more agency in my life lately. If not, suffice it to say that it feels like I've been at the mercy of too many external factors for far too long. As a result, my world has become very small this winter. I know I can't complain too much because I do live in paradise after all, but I'd be lying if I said I didn't feel like I've been skiing at least a little bit out of control this season. Fortunately, I do possess the appropriate technical knowledge to deal with the terrain in front of me, so I'm just going to stay the course and keep putting that knowledge into practice until I make it down that hill safely, and hopefully with a little bit of style. Okay, folks, we've reached the end of this presentation, so I thank you for tuning in. I hope you've enjoyed the show. If so, please hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any feedback or questions, post it in the comment section below. If you want to read previous newsletters, visit jaredmanninen.com and then check out my backcountry blog, tahotrailguide.com, where I offer information about hiking, backpacking, cross-country skiing, and snowshoeing at Lake Tahoe. I also write general and how-to articles about those activities, as well as informative articles about Sierra Nevada, flora and fauna, and the local history of Lake Tahoe. Thanks again, and take care, everyone.